Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 3.2, Problem 2. This is Section 3.2, Problem number 2. It says, consider the sample 32, 25, 28, 24, and 36. Find the range, find the variance, and find the standard deviation. So the range is simply the largest data value minus the smallest. So as you look at the data we have, the biggest one is 36. So we'll do 36 minus, and the smallest one is 24. So 36 minus 24 is 12. We have a range of 12. The next part wants us to find the variance. To find the variance, we do a four-step process. Step one is find the mean. Label it x bar. So we'll have x bar equals, and we'll add these numbers, 32 plus 25 plus 28 plus 24 plus 36, and we'll divide that by 5 because there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 data values. Now as we add up the top, 32 plus 25 would be 57. 57 and 28 will be 85. 85 and 24 is 109. 109 plus 36 is 145. And we'll divide that by 5. So that comes out to 29. Again, you could do that with your calculator. 145 divided by 5. So that's step one. Find the mean, label it x bar. Step two, fill out the chart. So the chart that we fill out has three columns. The first is labeled x, the middle is x minus x bar, and the last one is x minus x bar in parentheses raised to the second power. So the first column, x, is just the data that's given in the problem. So for this problem, it's 32, 25, 28, 24, and 36. So in every row, you're going to take the value of x that you have for that row and subtract off the x bar, which for this problem is 29. So in the top row, when x is 32, x minus x bar is 32 minus 29. And if you do the subtraction, you get 3, positive 3. The next row down, x is 25, so x minus x bar is 25 minus 29. That would be negative 4. The middle row, x is 28, so x minus x bar would be 28 minus 25. Oh, not 25, 29. 28 minus 29 is negative 1. The next row, x is 24, so x minus x bar is 24 minus 29. That's negative 5. And finally, in the bottom row, x minus x bar will be 36. Minus 29 is positive 7. Now, at this point, it's not a bad check to see if your total of your middle column has a total of 0. So if I find my positives, positive 3, positive 7 is positive 10. The negatives, negative 4, negative 1, negative 5 is negative 10. I do get a total of 0. So that's a good sign. If you don't have 0, you must have made a mistake somewhere. So now what we're going to do is take the results of x minus x bar and raise each answer to the second power. So in the top row, x minus x bar was 3, so I have 3 second power, which is 3 times 3, which gives me a 9. The next row down, x minus x bar was negative 4, so I'll do negative 4 second power. Negative 4 times negative 4, of course, is positive 16. You have to remember the negatives will cancel. The middle row, x minus x bar was minus 1, so I'll do minus 1 second power. Minus 1 times minus 1 is positive 1. Next row down, x minus x bar was negative 5, so I'll do negative 5 second power. Negative 5 times negative 5 is positive 25. And then finally in the bottom row, x minus x bar was 7, so 7 second power, 7 times 7 is 49. So that's step two of four steps, which is fill out the chart. There it is, we filled it out. Step three, get a total of the last column. So 9 plus 16 is 25. And I can add 25 and 25 is 50. 1 and 49 is another 50. 50 and 50, 100. Or you can do 9 and 16 is 25, plus 1 is 26, plus 25 is 51, plus 49 is 100. You could add going straight down, but I saw that I could group it in a certain way to make it easier. So the result of step 3, total of the last column, is 100. Step 4, take the result from step 3 and divide it by n minus 1 for a sample and divide by n for a population. Since this problem is a sample, I will divide my result from step 3 by n minus 1. N is how many data values we have. We have 5 data values in this problem. So n minus 1 becomes 5 minus 1. So I have my total from step 3, which is 100. I'm going to divide that by 4. 100 divided by 4 is 25. So that's the variance. The variance is 25. And again, if you want to use the symbols, since this is a sample, the symbol for variance is S second power. And then, if you want to find the standard deviation, it will be the square root of the variance, and the symbol is just S. S for standard deviation, lowercase, square root of 25 is 5.